So back in 2016, guys, Adidas has decided to bring us this new technology, which they actually introduced it in this new range, which is called the Ultraboost. And since then, of course, we got almost every year a different revised version. And in today's video, guys, we're actually gonna have a look at an Ultraboost, which is actually a tribute to the City of London. Hello guys, and welcome back for a brand new review. If you are new to the channel, please make sure you're gonna subscribe. You can also give me a follow on Instagram to see exactly what I'm gonna review in the next few days. So in today's video, guys, we're gonna have a look at this new version for the very well-known Ultraboost. So let's go ahead and take them out of the box, which as you can see will be in your usual box, which has this very interesting opening system. So let's go ahead and take them out. So in today's video, guys, we're gonna have a look at this last version for the Ultraboost, which is called the Underground Goretex. Apparently, guys, this Underground Goretex, it's actually a tribute to the City of London. And of course, this one will also include the very well-known Gore-Tex, which seems that Adidas is trying to push in a lot of their shoes. So this new model, guys, which is called the Underground Goretex, as you can see, it's actually based on the very iconic Ultraboost 1.0, and it will use roughly the same materials and of course the same Boost midsole, which in my opinion it's still one of the best which you can actually find on the market now. But this one, of course, will also have this Goretex material, which will actually be a waterproof, and most definitely this one will be a very good shoe for the wet seasons, and I would also say for the cold ones. Either way, guys, we had this Ultraboost Goretex released here in the UK for the retail price of £115. So let's go ahead and also do a breakdown of this one, guys. So as you can see, for the upper we're gonna have a mix of materials, one of it being this prime knit material, which actually is almost the same as the original Ultraboost. But this one, I think it also has some other materials in it. But of course, on top of it, we're also gonna have some rubberized material, which of course will need to give us some more protection against water and also other elements. But rather than that, guys, as you can see, for the upper, we're gonna have roughly the same structure as a normal Ultraboost 1.0. And I'm referring to this plastic cage on each side, and also this TPU counter heel support, which will be completely the same. But for this one, guys, as you can see, we're gonna have a different lacing system, which will actually start slightly a bit lower than your normal cage. So this one, as you can see, will have these loopholes here at the bottom, and this one will actually not use your normal laces. As you can see, we're gonna have this very thin straps. But this one, you will also have this system which will tighten very nicely this whole laces. Continuing now in the midfoot, guys, we're gonna have this plastic cage in this black color, which will have your normal punch out holes for the laces. And just underneath this so-called lacing system, guys, as you can see, we're gonna have three different types of material. But as you go towards the back of the shoe, guys, you can see that we're gonna have this black counter heel support, which will be totally the same as the original one released back in 2016. And of course, here on the lateral side, we're also gonna have written Ultraboost. In this case, will be in this silver color. And just above this heel counter support, guys, we're gonna have this material, which it's completely as the one released back in 2016. And just as we go inside, guys, we're gonna have a black lining. And just under this lining, we're gonna have actually a very good amount of padding, which will actually keep your whole ankle and heel section quite good in place. But this lining, guys, as we go towards the footbed, will change into this Gore-Tex material, which will actually wrap your whole foot, and that will be just perfect to keep you protected against the water. Of course, inside we're also gonna have this black foam insole, which will have written very big here at the heel section, Boost, in this white color. And just at the back of the shoe, guys, above the actual heel section, we're also gonna have this very interesting pull tab, which will also have these three stripes in this silver color. Now, guys, we can go to this Boost midsole, which will be in this black color. So this one will be completely the same as the original one, so nothing changed here. This one, to be honest, in my opinion, even though it's 6 years old, it still provides a very good support and a level of comfort. And now, guys, we can finish with this continental rubber outsole, which, as you can see, will also have a raised pattern. So this one most definitely will give you a very good support and also a grip. Of course, here in the midfoot, we're also gonna have this torsion system, which will be in this yellow color. And so, in my opinion, this rubberized outsole, guys, it's also having a rugged design. And of course, this one will actually go in tone with the rest of the shoe, which I guess, in my opinion, tries to replicate slightly the grit conditions in London and, to be honest, in all of the UK. As in for the actual sizing, guys, for this one I went with my true to size, which I also made with the original Ultraboost 1.0. And this one, for me, as I have a skinny feet, fits me just fine. And I guess it will be roughly the same for people with normal feet. But just in case you have wider feet, I would suggest you to go with either true to size or even try to go with a half size up. And that would be mainly because this whole shoe is not gonna be a wide one, and as this one will have this Gore-Tex lining underneath. Most definitely it will not flex too much, and even this material on the outside is not too stretchable, so most definitely you will find that to be slightly a bit too tight. So overall, guys, this new version for the Ultra Boost, which is called the Underground and also has this Gore-Tex materials, in my opinion really looks very nice and has quite good materials. But to be honest, when we are talking about the Gore-Tex versions, we're also gonna have a lot of rubberized materials on the outside, which most definitely will make the whole shoe slightly a bit rigid, but I guess that will change slightly in time as it will start to give in. So yeah, guys, this was my unboxing and reviewing of this Ultraboost Underground Gore-Tex. I really hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to press the like button, maybe also subscribe to the channel. You can also give me a follow on Instagram to see exactly what I'm gonna review in the next few days. And as always, I will see you in my next one. Thanks for watching!